Linus Tech Tips, a popular YouTuber with channels boasting millions of subscribers, was hacked this week.
My life's work vanishing before my eyes. Linus Tech Tips, deleted. Tech Linked, toasted. Tech Quickie, gone.
Linus is a tech expert who consistently advocates strong password protections and 2FA. So how did his accounts get hacked? In this video, we'll explain exactly what happened and how you can protect yourself from a similar attack. The scary thing is how common hacks like this are. Protecting yourself requires a lot of vigilance, but YouTube also needs to bump up their security, and we'll explain why. So let's dive in. Linus woke abruptly in the middle of the night this week to find his life's work in shambles. Yes, this is him walking around his house, but naked. Let's hope he wasn't using any of these home cameras. Hackers had taken over. Channels were renamed to Tesla and were playing what seemed to be a live stream of Elon Musk discussing cryptocurrency. This trick is stupidly common on YouTube. Hackers find an existing live stream from someone important and make it look like that stream is happening in real time. To a viewer, these can be indistinguishable. Due to the channel's high reach, hundreds of thousands of people get pinged about the live stream and tune in. This makes the stream look really legit. Surely hundreds of thousands of people wouldn't be watching if this were a scam. The subscriber count of the channel itself adds to the look of legitimacy. This must be Tesla's real channel because they have 15 million subscribers and there's a verified checkmark. The ultimate aim of these hackers is to get a viewer to click on their scam website, where they'd steal your Bitcoin. The interesting part is that Linus hadn't actually lost access to his accounts. He was able to log in, make the streams private, revoke the stream key, and reset his account credentials. Problem fixed, right? Not quite. Immediately, the hackers were back in. Only now, they were mass deleting videos from the channels. Changing the credentials didn't help, because these hackers had never actually gotten access to these login credentials in the first place. They also hadn't compromised Linus's 2FA. So what had actually happened? Session tokens. What is a session token? It's often in the form of a cookie. No, not that kind of cookie. Where a small piece of data is stored on the user's computer by their web browser. Basically, once a website validates a user's account credentials when they log in, the website's server creates a unique session token or session ID, sends it to the user's browser, and the browser will store it as a cookie. When you explore a website, there are many requests made to the website's server as you submit forms, explore different pages, etc. You don't want to have to keep typing in your password after every single action you perform. So the session token tells the website, this person has already been verified. This way, the person stays logged in as they use the site. It turns out that these session tokens can actually be stolen. Yep.
These cookies are delicious.
A hacker doesn't necessarily have to steal your password and your 2FA method in order to access your account. If they can steal your session token, the website will think that they've been verified and grant them access. This is what happened to Linus.
Someone on our team, and I'm not saying it was Colton, downloaded what appeared to be a sponsorship offer from a potential partner.
Basically, someone on his team received a legitimate looking email from some potential sponsor and downloaded what appeared to be a PDF containing terms of the deal. What they'd actually downloaded was malware, and in the background, it had accessed all user data from both of their installed browsers, like locally saved passwords, browser preferences, and cookies. This basically gave the hacker an exact copy of this person's browser, which included all the session tokens to every account he was logged into. The hacker could now trick the website into letting them into Linus's account because they had the token that said, this person is verified and allowed access. This is where YouTube or Google has really dropped the ball. Session cookies are usually temporary and expire when the user logs out, closes their browser, signs in from an unrecognized IP address, or after a predetermined period of inactivity. This helps to protect user accounts from unauthorized access. You'll notice this happening when you suddenly get a pop-up that says, are you still there? Logging you out in 30 seconds. When it does log you out, your session token will expire. But on platforms based on social engagement, where you like, comment on, and share content, you'll rarely, if ever, see these timeouts. That's because companies like Twitter, Facebook, and YouTube want to remove as much friction as possible when you're using your accounts to keep you on their sites as long as possible. It doesn't seem like YouTube has proper security policies in place around session tokens. Hacks like the one Linus experienced happen regularly. You'll notice that these live streaming scams are ridiculously common on YouTube.
How is this crap not only still possible, but so prevalent?
Linus mentions in his video that, given how frequently these account takeovers and live stream scams happen, YouTube at a bare minimum should have time-based expiry for session tokens, and perhaps there should also be other precautions in place. He also brought up some great questions, like why is it possible to change the name of a channel without having to re-enter your password and authenticate with your two-factor? Why is it possible to reset the stream key without re-verification? How can you delete 1,000 videos off someone's channel in a matter of minutes without the site asking, "Hey, is that really you?" These attacks keep on happening, so YouTube really needs to have some internal discussions about whether their current security practices are good enough. What Google does is somewhat out of your control. So what is in your control? Well, there are definitely precautions that you can take to help prevent something like this. Rule number 1, 2, 3, and 4, never click the link and don't download files from strangers. If a sales rep contacts you and asks you to look at an attached PDF for more details, just ask them to send that information in plain text instead. We all mess up and accidentally click things we shouldn't, so it can also be helpful to have different devices for different activities. This can allow you to silo more sensitive activity on one machine and silo activities where you're more likely to accidentally download a malicious file on another. You don't even need different devices to silo activity. You can also use something like Tails, which is an alternative operating system that you can boot up from a thumb drive that sort of creates a sandbox for your activity. So if you need to open attachments for a living, you could do so while using Tails, and your session and memory would be wiped after you log out so that whatever you did in that session can't hurt the rest of your computer. And if you have an account where multiple people have access, it's important to implement the rule of least privilege, which is where you grant a user account as few privileges as possible, only what's necessary for them to perform their roles. This helps decrease your attack surface by limiting how many people have access to important account features. It really sucks what happened to Linus, and hats off to his community that went out of their way to warn him and the livestream viewers about the attack. Security is super hard, and we all slip up. Events like this can remind us of ways that we can beef up our own security by adding different layers of protection like the ones we've mentioned. It's not bulletproof, but every little bit helps. We couldn't make these videos without your support. A huge thank you to all community members who help us make our free educational content. Visit nbtv.media/support if you'd like to be added to our wall of champions. We also have an ebook, and all proceeds also support our channel. Thank you so much for watching through till the end, and please hit that subscribe button and like button before you go.
I should think of more ways to integrate cookies into my videos.